Hi guys, these what you see are a few old lithium ion cells. Now these cells actually died 10 years back from now and I discarded them for that very reason. But after so many years when I checked them back, they revived and I don't know how that is possible, but it did happen. Although the cell voltages are different, hence this video. Now this is a transformer with only 220 volts primary winding and no secondary winding. And this is my 1 mm super thick copper wire for secondary winding. Now here as you can see that I'm giving it 3 turns on the secondary to figure out the voltage per turn. And here as you can see that we have 0.7 volts AC for 3 turns. So here I've given around 28 turns to the secondary and now it's time to measure the voltage that it is producing, which as you can see is exactly 6.6 volts as I wanted. This video is sponsored by NextPCB, which offers you 10 pieces of 1 to 4 layers of PCBs without any cost. Also, now you can upload Gerber files without filling the data one by one. New users are also getting $100 of joining bonus after they register to the NextPCB website. Links in the description. So guys, here I've used 7 pieces of 1N4007 diodes and all of them have been connected in series to prevent the supply voltage from rising beyond 4.2 volts. ohms resistor. Thank you. link for the files to download this type of box and 3D print yourself has been provided in the description. So don't forget to check it out. It fits the batteries perfectly, and at present also it is balancing the batteries since all of them have been connected in parallel. So let's check the overall voltage that we have gained, and it's simple and easy. Simply slide the cover like this, and this is for easy slide, like very easy. And this is the stiff side, little stiff, so it's not going to come out easily. So both the provisions are available. Testing it, seems like no connection is there in between here and here. Let's try this side, and here we have it, 3.4 volts. So the batteries are obviously discharged. This side is positive, and here we have plus 3.4 volts. It's also connected to this one and this one. So four batteries are under balancing, and these batteries are under balancing with their neighboring cells. So guys, the circuit is fully complete now. It's time to test its output voltage. And we also have an LED indicator that is going to indicate that our circuit has turned on. Now guys, 220 volts is going to come from this side, and this is the transformer, which is in turn going to produce 6.6 volts, which we have already seen. This is the input side of this circuit. So the connections have been made. Let's turn on the switch. And here the LED bulb has started glowing, indicating that the circuit is on. And here, as you can see, that we are producing a safe voltage of around 3.9 volts DC for our lithium ion battery pack. Now here I've already marked the positive and negative side. You see that's negative and this one is positive. And here I've also soldered this piece with my spot welding machine, and this is going to be the positive and this is going to be the negative on one single side. It's going to be easier. And the best part is that you see these spaces here, that is going to be very useful for placing these like this. So we have like positive over there and a negative over here, so it's 3.6 volts almost. Now negative will be connected like this and positive, and here as you can see that it has started charging. So let's test our battery with this 12 volts bulb, and you see that it's working. Cool.